The boat at left has a gyroscope that prevents the waves from rocking it left to right. We see the boat at right rocking in the waves right to left. Furthermore, in preventing the boat from rocking left to right, the gyroscope itself moves from front to back, as shown in this animation. How can they do that? Well, we use gyroscopic stabilization all the time. For instance, with this frisbee. This frisbee is flying, when we touch it, it'll tumble. But because I push on it, and that edge goes up. However, if it's spinning, we can see that when I hit it, it doesn't turn very far. It's very stable. Furthermore, we notice when I try to turn it this way, it actually turns this way. Why is that? If you get pushed while you're not moving, you just go in the direction that you were pushed. However, if you're already moving, the impulse that you receive is added to your initial momentum to give you your final momentum, and this determines your direction. And if you're moving faster, we see that this impulse affects your direction less. The edge of the frisbee closest to me is moving very quickly in that direction. It has a lot of momentum to my right. So when I hit it, it doesn't jump up here and continue to the right. It continues in this direction with its initial momentum, but gets an impulse from me, and so takes off at an angle. And rather than tip this way, the frisbee actually tips this way. Let's watch that again. We can also explain this in terms of angular momentum. When I put a torque on something, it increases or decreases its angular momentum. And we can define torque as the rate of change of angular momentum. And therefore, when I put a torque on something, I give it an angular impulse. That angular impulse, delta L, is equal to the torque times the amount of time that I'm applying that torque. So if a frisbee is stationary and I push upward on this rim, it applies a torque in this direction, which will result in giving the frisbee an angular impulse, delta L, in this direction. And sure enough, we can see that if I apply a torque in that direction, the frisbee gains angular momentum in that direction. But if already the frisbee is spinning very fast, it has some initial angular momentum, L0. So the final angular momentum will be the angular momentum it already has, plus the angular impulse I give it. And it will change orientation in a way that we don't really expect it to. So as I push the frisbee like this, it actually tips like this, and then remains stable again until another torque is put on it. When the gyroscope is not spinning, it's very easy to turn. It spins in the same direction as the torque I provide with my finger, giving it an angular impulse. However, if the gyroscope is already spinning, it has a large initial angular momentum, and the angular impulse I give it is added to its initial angular momentum, changing its direction only slightly. We also see that if I lock the gyroscope by tying it with strings, preventing it from changing orientation, it's very easy to turn again. Similarly, in this animation, when the gyroscope is locked, it does not provide any additional stability for the boat, and we see it rock back and forth. When the gyroscope is unlocked and free to change orientation, it stabilizes the boat. Let's take a look at this next wave. The angular momentum of the gyroscope is upwards. This wave is providing a torque into the board as shown, away from us.
providing an angular impulse that only changes the gyroscope's orientation by a small amount. Because the gyroscope had a very large angular momentum, it required a large torque in order to change its orientation. Thereby, the gyroscope provided a large counter-torque, which stabilized the boat from rocking. It's this counter-torque that is indicated by the green arrows in the animation. So we should be able to see how a spinning gyroscope can stabilize a vehicle by changing its orientation perpendicular to the direction that it provides torque.
Say hello, Marianne.